Okay, I'm gonna change out the thermostat again on my 2011 Dodge Grand Caravan. And the reason I'm doing it again, even though I've changed it out probably 10 times, is because I'm gonna put 180 degree thermostat on here. And here is what it is right here. It's the thermostat. And it actually, I can't remember, I think I got it at Summit Racing or something, but it's for Jeep Wranglers, but they have the same engine as we do. They have that housing that we do. And here's what it looks like. You can see it. It fits inside of the housing that goes on the thermostat. It's right here, right in there. Whenever I first took the drain plug loose for the radiator, nothing hardly came out. But to relieve pressure and to make it start flowing out, you just open this and then it'll start coming out. So I drain out some of the radiator fluid. But see, I just open it and now it's starting to come out. You don't have to drain all of it out, but you just need to at least get down below where the level is for that housing. Plus, I'm going to take the upper radiator hose off. And hang on a second. I'll be right back. I'm going to show you how to put the thermostat into the housing. Well, first of all, I'm going to take the other one out. First of all, I want to give a little bit of a backstory. Every year, I have issues with overheating. And I have always been real upset with Dodge. And I made that known through forums and the dealer and everywhere else that the thermostat that they have on there is unreliable and it opens too late. I've checked them out. I have purchased at least 10 of them. And they all open at different times, I feel, anywhere from 204 to 212 degrees. That's too hot. It is absolutely too hot. So, I don't want to burn up my motor. I got 315,000 miles. I take good care of my vehicle. I want to have a good, reliable thermostat. So, I got a low temp one, 180 degrees. And as soon as it drains out a little bit more, I plan to take this radiator hose loose, take the two 10 millimeter bolts out of the thermostat housing, and then I'll show you how to put the other one in. Okay, I got the hose loose, and I always prop it up right there. And I'm gonna tell you a little trick. After you get done working on the vehicle and you have drained the coolant out, the first place that you pour the coolant into after you get done is into this hose. And if you fill up this hose, after you've already secured all the connections, obviously, but when putting the coolant back in, if you fill up the hose first and then just keep filling it up until you put it back on, and then you won't have to worry about bleeding the thermostat as much as what you normally would. And you don't have to worry about cavitation or anything like that, because it used to be a real issue with me, but now, after I started doing that, I don't really have to adjust that bleed screw. And the thing is with that bleed screw, you adjust it and then you over tighten it, then you screw up the thing and you have to replace the whole thing anyway. So it's best to not have to adjust it at all, is my opinion. There's what you need to take out the thermostat housing. Quarter inch. You don't really need the extension, but you might. You never know. So I've got it anyway, and I believe it's a 10 millimeter nut down there, a bolt. And I'm gonna take it out. Most of the fluids, or at least half the fluids, are already drained out. Okay, I was just gonna put my arm in there and try to take it off without removing this stuff, but it kind of hurts. So it's a pain in the ass, but you gotta remove the air box, power steering pump. I know mine looks like it's leaking, but it's really not. It's old stuff. It's dried. Oh, it's not dry either. No, a guy that I had do some work for me one time, he cracked it, and I never have gotten it replaced, and it's got stuff in there. So I'm getting ready to suck it out and put some more in there, though. I'm always changing it out, changing out all my fluids all the time. So I'm going to remove that, get that out of the way, and tie the air box up so it's out of the way so I can get a clear access to the thermostat housing. Didn't happen to have to remove the air box. I just took the power steering reservoir and wedged it up there with the hose on top of it. So there's your thermostat housing, and looks like I got a zip tie right here. I'm getting ready to take it out, and I'll be right back. Okay, let me talk about something else. When you're taking this, if you're replacing your thermostat, just want to let you know that on the hose there is a mark right here. That mark lines up with this little nipple thing that's underneath this hose. The mark on the hose lines up with that little nipple thing right there, which also lines up with the thermostat adjustment screw. That's where you need whenever. So don't mount the thermostat on the thing and then try to put the hose on. Put the hose on, put it in the right position, put a clamp on it. And on this particular case, since the thermostat's only about a week old, the housings works and the bleed screws doesn't leak. And let me tell you, if you have like a pinhole leak in this thing, you'll lose your water, you'll overheat. It'll drive you nuts trying to find out what it is. Okay. See how the thermostat is mounted into the underneath that thing? You're just gonna take that little mounting plate, take the mounting spring. You're gonna put the other one in there, put the spring on top, and then put it back underneath there, just like that one. God. I wanted to show you one more thing. On this new thermostat that I have, it says, however you say that, Menshumito 82 degrees Celsius. Okay, that's the new one. This one doesn't have anything written on it. See how it's got a shorter thingy right there, and this one's longer. I don't know if it says the actual probe or what, but anyway, I'll have to do calculations, see what 82 degrees Celsius is, but it's supposed to be 180 degrees. That's what the box says. That's what I'm hoping, and it says it's for a, 180 degrees, 82 Celsius. I don't know if you can see this because I can't see out in the sun here, but it says for 3.6 Jeep Wrangler. Now, some of the sites I went to, I had a hard time. Well, I couldn't order the thing because they only put it as being the Jeep Wrangler being the qualified vehicle. But you just have to keep on shopping. Okay. Thermostat in the hole like so. That probe is actually longer. And see how it is raised up a little bit? Oh, shit. I lose my... God dang it. Alright. This is where the tension of the spring comes in. So I'm going to put the spring on here, like so. Then I'm going to put this on here, press the spring down, and put it underneath that little bracket. And you can see that there are little grooves right there on the end of that little bracket. And there actually happens to be a place on the thermostat where the housing, where the bracket fits. And another thing, if you go to the dealer to get the thermostat, the regular one, they sell these as separate. I think it's like $10 or $11 for the actual thermostat right here. But the housing is only like $15. But a lot of dealers are trying to sell them as one unit. And maybe you have to buy it like that, but I noticed they priced them, one of the dealers priced them separately and one priced it as combined one piece. The one that priced them separately probably ripped me off. But, oh yeah, another thing. If you're going to buy this, whatever, however you say this, Mishimoto thermostat, you're going to pay $44, $48 just for the thermostat, and then you have to pay about $11, $12 shipping. You're not going to find it at the regular O'Reilly's, AutoZone, Advanced Auto Parts, any of that stuff. You're going to have to order it online. They know that this thing is valuable. They know about the situation with the Dodge Grand Caravan. They know about the situation with the overheating of this 3.6 liter Pentastar engine. So, you're going to pay for this thermostat. If you want it, it costs me $48 plus about $12 shipping. Oh, actually, no, I didn't pay for the shipping. I don't think I did. I can't remember. Anyway, I didn't care how much it cost. I just wanted it. I don't want to burn up my motor. It's the beginning of the summer. Actually, it's still spring. It's May the 6th. And I know I do a lot of idling in my car, in my vehicle, with air conditioner running. I can sit hours and hours at a time without even moving. Just running the engine. Run the AC. Not very good for... the engine staying cool. So this is what I'm getting to remedy that problem, and I will let you know if it works. But first of all, if I get it back in here, piece of cake. It's not hard to press that spring down. It's back in there. I just washed it off, getting ready to slide this puppy back in here, and I'm gonna bolt it back down, fill up the radiator hose with coolant, well, after I strain it out. And I use Mopar coolant. People say, why would you want to buy this stuff? It's expensive. But here's the thing. And this one, 5-year, I think 100,000 miles.